Welcome back to New Day Cleveland. Okay, coming up in this half hour, we're checking out the essentials for any trip that you're going to be planning, plus custom cars, trucks, antique construction equipment, planes. The list goes on. We're giving you a sneak peek at a huge event happening in Cleveland this weekend. But first, sit back, relax, and how about sipping on a spring sangria? That's what we're making with Ryan Haddich from your wine cellar in Strongsville. I saw all that snow in our shots, and I'm thinking, no, we're here with you, and it's time to think spring and enjoy a nice spritzer drink.
Exactly. That's what we're going to be doing today. I'm going to make up three different types that are going to be delightful for your springtime enjoyment.
And you know a thing or two about this. Not only do you have the wine cellar, but you also teach classes.
That's correct.
On this?
I'm teaching at Kent State University. There's a program in winemaking and also in grape growing at Kent State Ashtabula, and we're currently enrolling for fall semester.
That's amazing. Okay, so you're going to make this simple for us, right?
Absolutely.
Okay.
This is going to be easy and lots of fun.
I see three different pitchers, so we're making three different types?
That's correct.
I love this. All right, well, I'll just let you start with the first and show me what to do.
The first one that we're going to make, we're going to do light fruit with some lemons and limes and some grapes. So we're going to go ahead and put those into the pitcher here. And
just look at how colorful and beautiful it looks.
Oh, there goes one.
Rogue.
Got a roller.
Just a little rogue. You know what that means. Just eat it.
Yep. It's going to be delicious. All right. So some grapes in there. And now we're going to use a red wine for this one. This is Red Velvet Merlot made at your wine cellar. And I'm going to mix this with a cran cherry.
Is it equal parts?
Yeah,
juice
normally,
to wine, or what is it?
You know, I generally will just, I'll do equal parts, but you can do whatever you'd like. Some people like to add liquor to their sangrias. I generally, because I'm a winemaker, I like to add wine. And usually, you know, you just use whatever you have in your fridge. So so here's our first one. You've got a glass right over there to taste this.
Look at how beautiful that looks.
And this is just going to be a really nice, light, easy to drink.
Is the key to also having really
fresh
and
you want
fruit?
Yes, you want the fresh fruit, so let's grab some.
Oh, yes.
Some fruit for that as well. There we go.
Plop that right in.
That
one's not going to go, so we're just going to put that.
Our first sangria there. Mm. And then, who has it?
That's delicious.
Yeah, awesome.
It's amazing how the cranberry, you know, if you're not that much of a wine drinker, that's why I think a lot of people really can get into sangria, because sometimes people don't like wine, but you can still drink sangria, because the juices mask a lot of
exactly. It makes it light and easy to drink, and just friendly for those who don't normally like wine.
That's delicious.
All right, so the next one I'm excited about. This is going to be more like a spritzer. And what we're going to do is we're going to take some strawberries.
Yeah,
and
you don't need all of those.
Oh, okay. No, go ahead.
I need to try like one of each fruit.
Yeah. And so we're going to put all that into our little pitcher here.
Ooh, raspberries are my favorite, so I have a feeling this is going to be.
Yeah, this will be delightful.
Delicious to me. So how do you pick? I mean, you went with the dark wine with the lemons and limes and grapes. How do you decide which is best to go with what fruit?
Whatever's in your fridge. You know,
really?
There's really no specific formula for it. Generally, I like to do, if I'm using a red wine, I like to use some citrus to brighten it up a little bit. And that's my formula, but generally sangrias are just whatever you have around.
This just looks so fresh.
We're using raspberry ginger ale. We're using strawberry white Merlot from your wine cellar. And we're in Strongsville, 8385 Pearl Road, next to the Brew Kettle, where we have amazing smokehouse-style barbecue food and brew your own beer, and you can make your own wine at your wine cellar.
Wow.
Using white cranberry.
You can make your own wine there,
too. You can make your own wine, yep. So you can make any of this that we're using today, you can make. So this is our strawberry white Merlot mixed with white cran, peach, and raspberry ginger ale.
Give me that. So if you think about it, how beautiful would that be if you're having friends over for a nice lunch or something and you're serving this
exactly
as your side instead of your average drink? I love this.
Oh, there's your raspberry. All right, and then
last
but not least, we're going to use California Moscato, and this is our number one seller. This one has the silver medal in international competition, so we're going to pour some California Moscato.
This one you just poured should be too. Wow.
Yeah, delicious.
This is award winning right here.
Oh, thank you. Mm. And I'm using a new juice I haven't seen by Ocean Spray called Wave. This is mango pineapple. And so I've got some pineapples and mangoes I'm going to throw in it right here.
Oh my gosh.
Mix those together and then throw in our mangoes and pineapples.
So how long can this sit in a refrigerator? It's okay. We like a mess here.
We're making a mess.
How long can this sit in a refrigerator and still be good?
A couple days.
Okay.
Yeah, generally, open wine will last 2 or 3 days, and as long as it's covered, you should be fine for a couple days there. And so
all of this wine you're getting from your wine cellar.
All this wine is from your wine cellar in Strongsville, and so I don't know where other glasses are.
I'm just kidding. I would never really do that.
But we've got the mango pineapple here as well.
Okay. So really, any type of fruit will work.
Any type of fruit, any combination. Yes. The recipe for sangria is fruit, juice, and wine. And if you've got a little liquor and you want to spice it up, you can do that as well.
I love the sound of this. Three different just wonderful drinks that you can have this spring and in the summer. Really freshen up any meal.
Sangria is great year-round. If you're ever wanting a taste of springtime or summer when it's still cold outside, this is a great way to bring it in, bring the beach to your living room.
I love it. Go check them out in Strongsville, your wine cellar. Thank you so much for being here.
Thanks for having me.
So good to have you here, Rayanne. All right, David?